the mines from like full stage. Showtime. One,
go. All right, let's see what we got here.
Go right in for a grab.
All right, go ahead. Let's smash DI out of the down air.
So you wanna smash DI?
Oh my God! I forgot. Yeah. So transforming to Zelda
gets rid of the stick.
I haven't seen any Zeldas like really use it. I mean, I can't say that I've seen this matchup a whole lot. Now the tricky thing is he is now like, yeah, he has to switch back. That's the problem.
Oh, meaty. That was the definition of a meaty. Let's go.
Yeah. I'm wondering if it'd be worth to just like set off your instead of like trying to. I guess you can punish the transform. Probably better than setting off your C4 during
that
time.
You can't punish it.
Yeah, like
you act out immediately.
Okay.
But he put a down air in the area because transformation time varies depending on the build and like the loading.
That's right.
Method.
Yeah.
Like how much data's on the build. And how power, like whatever is loaded by. So he put out a down air, which is like 80 active frames, and it covered every possible timing.
Isn't it like quicker to? Oh, doesn't grab ledge. Isn't it quicker if you've like already transformed once?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think what would be interesting is if like Zelda Sheik, like if you are gonna transform, you start off as like one of them and then immediately switch.
I believe it's also faster going from one to the other.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, Nito's hit it. So Flip gets a lot of mileage off of people trying to get in on him. And I don't think Oates cares. He's just gonna... No. Yeah, Oates does not care. He's gonna face this 10. Those grenade lobs are actually gonna be big though. If he can get the grenade in over the needles, that's like the 3%. He'll trade needle damage, but I think percent on Sheik is more important than percent on Snake.
So the needles, like Sheik's like to use.
Oh, oh wow!
Oh, and that wouldn't my. Even if he had air dodge through it though, he wouldn't have like.
He would have died.
He still died. Yeah.
No, I think he wanted it. SDI in the tech.
Oh, I can see that. Yeah. Okay. What I was gonna say is, a lot of Sheiks like to edgeguard with needles. That's not really gonna work against Snake because of that Cypher.
It's gonna
unless
you like.
Up.
Clip his toes.
Yeah, I wonder if a fully charged needles. No, because it's gonna.
And you. Oh my gosh, this combo. That was.
Yeah, I don't think transform is gonna be viable in this matchup unless. Oh.
Okay.
But no, this unless man, he can like play a good Zelda.
But
though,
now he dies super early.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's true.
All right, that was a good call.
Yeah.
Up
that
throw.
Should do it. Yeah. You know. I don't know. I don't know. I can't tell if that's actually viable or not. The transform. Because it gets it off of it,
if
and you can act immediately.
You have a good Zelda.
Yeah.
I like that spacing.
Get up there.
Oates did on the shield because when Snake pulls the grenade and shields, he's holding it behind him.
Oh really?
Okay. Yeah. Like, or he drops. He starts holding.
Oh
behind
right.
Him,
he's like he crouched over. Yeah. He's just like crouched over. Holding
he's
it by
his
back, yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Oh, his shield's almost burst. Yeah, but like Oates is like forward air to shield and then jabs twice in the front. And he wasn't gonna get shield grabbed. Or actually could have actually, I guess, but.
Yeah, actually Oates does have the Flip does have poor priority.
Yeah.
I'd like to see him run up and like if he can put like a mine there or something.
Yeah, something meaty.
Yeah.
Like meaty in a traditional fighter sense where the active hitboxes are out while the person is becoming active or vulnerable.
Right.
So they're forced to hold shield.
So, I'm pretty...
Oh, fuck. Hyperflame.
Okay.
Trade?
Okay, so what Z-Man said is that Jolteon in the chat said it's really good if you can trade with Transform. Not totally sure what he would trade with, but...
Maybe that... I can just check the chat or something.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I can see it. Oh, that was... He suplexed him into a grenade. That's some WWE shit.
Is Flip sponsored? I'm looking at that shirt that he's wearing.
It's
got Smash Boards on it and some sort of
and
logo on it.
I don't think he's sponsored. I don't know if he's sponsored. I need a shirt with Smash Boards on it.
So I like this costume for Oates. So it's like basically the green costume, but he's got like I think it's a tiger sleeve.
Oh.
He has some sort of sleeve on. You can kind of see it.
Really
on the arms. Yeah, stop moving and then stop getting hit by grenades. But yeah,
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Alright, so let's see.
So, last game, Oats had a big lead, and then Flip just walked it back. Oh, there he is. He's dead, though.
Yeah. I think a Nair would have probably been better there.
I
wouldn't have killed, but...
I don't want to trade stock versus Snake. I don't know about
you.
Because he lives off trades.
That's right.
Oats doesn't seem to have an answer with these downers on shield. Because it flipped them there at the timing of when he's going to land.
Yeah.
So it's going to make it hard to know when to Nair to shield or shield grab. I believe it's not true shield swap block either, but you can't roll. So if you drop shield and try to roll, you get hit. Some characters have throws that when you grab them with a grenade, you can just avoid the explosion entirely. I don't think she can do that. Like, she doesn't displace herself when she throws at all. Looks like Flip has a big lead and Oats can't seem to wait, find a way to get in.
Oh my gosh. Almost got off stage with that down air.
Oh, good fair. Disrespect the other forward air. Oh, he's dead.
Bomb falls.
Oh, never mind. He's not high, man.
There it is.
This is looking rough.
Fresh popping off over here.
Oh.
Fresh legit pops off to anything, actually. Like, someone, Chip apparently, like, walked by Fresh and was like, oh, hey, man. And Chip's like, yo, what's good, baby? Like, he's just, dude's a riot. I really like the energy that he has.
Oh, that was cute.
Wow, good stick.
Sticky, and ended up
right on the upper thigh.
I don't know what move it was, but that was cute.
That'll do it.
He did like a falling arrow after the stick to like hit him off the ground so he couldn't tech. That was cute.
So up next, I think we have Isle of Bagels versus Junebug.
That'll be interesting.
That'll be fun.
Do better than luck. Savage.
No, that's
okay. Let's get all the jokes out now. All
right. Yeah. All right. Someone call Junebug right now. Call him.
Call him right now. Give him
a call.
Don't die to Uppy as you.
Did you and Bagels talk about like any Diddy stuff?
We talked about the matchup a good amount.
Good.
Yeah.
All right.
Diddy is great.
Master.
I know this matchup. I don't know like it completely in and out, but I know that the way Junebug plays is what beats Diddy. Is what makes Diddy. Or what beats Luigi. Is what makes Diddy win the matchup. Is dash dancing with a banana and like bear spacing. Because Luigi can't get in. If you leave the banana in a position where Luigi can't wave dash over it immediately, and then put a bear wall out. Because like a high bear will beat out like everything except for up smash, and the low bear will hit Luigi's legs on the up smash ahead of time, or he'll trip. Oh. Yeah, like dash dancing is really good. And back air just completely edgeguards Luigi completely. Just back air, rinse and repeat.
You see that, yeah.
Because Diddy's back air is Falcon's back air mixed with Puff.
Really? Oh, I guess I can see that, yeah.
The way he swings is like Puff back air, but it's Falcon back air strength and not angle, like trajectory almost. Okay. It's really good.
June picked Ganon?
Okay, we'll see.
Maybe he's trying to slow the match down, get a better feel. I don't know that he's played a really good Luigi before.
He's played X, XYK, and they went pretty close.